Hello creatives, I'm Joanna Penn and in today's video I'm talking about how to market your audiobook. And this is, I guess, a little excerpt from my book Audio for Authors, which is about audiobooks, podcasting and voice technologies. So first of all, the audiobook format is just another format. So if you're marketing your book in any way and linking to your website or to a sales page, and if people prefer the audio edition, then they're going to buy that. So for example, if I hear an interview with somebody on a podcast, the first thing I'm going to do is check if their book is available in audio because I like listening to things. So I might not buy that book in ebook or print format. I might want it in audio. So that's the first thing to remember. It really is about marketing all formats. Of course, you want to make sure that all the formats are linked. So on Amazon, you can just log into Amazon Author Central and ask for your editions to be linked if it doesn't happen or automatically. If you publish wide, you can use books2read.com where you can add in audiobook links as well as other links, so you only have one to share on social media, which is super useful. The next thing you should do is make sure you have a landing page on your own website for all of your audio editions. For example, if you go to thecreativepen.com/audio, you're going to find samples of all my audiobooks and links to where you can buy them. If you publish on ACX, you can even get bounty links, which will give you extra money if people click through and buy using your link. So you can use those on your website too. And of course, make sure you have an Audible author page, which will be populated with all of the audiobooks under your author name. You can then promote this to Audible listeners specifically so they can find all of your books. Another tip is to use audiograms, which are an audio snippet played as a small video that can be used on social media, for example, on Instagram or YouTube or Twitter. You can use a tool like Headliner app, which will help you create a little video with a waveform over it. And you can play an example from my book, Productivity for Authors, at thecreativepen.com/audiogram. You can also use social media to share images and quotes with links to your audiobook. I use canva.com to create appropriately sized images, and of course, all the social networks have different sized images, but Canva allows you to manipulate things, which is super useful. You could also use quotes from your audiobook or a picture of a cell phone with some headphones or other types of images and words with a link to your audio. You can also use soundcloud.com to create shareable audio with really useful links so you can embed it into your Facebook page or your website and also link back to the buy page. You can also use paid advertising, for example, Facebook ads that direct people back to your buy page on the various stores or to your website with all your links on. You can also include audio in your email autoresponder sequence. So if you have email sign up, and of course you should have email sign up, then you can add in an extra email that says, if you like audiobooks, click here to find a list of my available audio. You have to remember that a lot of people prefer listening to listening with their ears or reading with their ears than reading with their eyes these days. So if you tell people that it's available, more people might buy. You can use giveaway codes to get reviews. ACX provides promo codes if you exclusively publish with them, and Findaway Voices also has promo codes for authors direct, which are available in some countries. So these services can help you get more reviews. Another good idea is to market to library patrons, because of course anyone with a library card can listen to audiobooks and read ebooks through their library app. If you publish through Findaway Voices, your audiobook will be available on the library apps. This is a win-win for you and your readers because you can say, hey, you can get my books for free if you download them on your library app or maybe request them into your local library, and you will get paid sometimes for the checkout and sometimes for a sale. Yes, and you can get my audiobooks for free if you request them on your library app. So as you can see, it really is a win-win for everyone. Another option is to promote your ebook in order to sell more audiobooks, and this is a really good hack. So basically, if I own an ebook and I've bought one, say, on a discount deal for 99p or 99 cents or got it for free, I can get the audiobook for much cheaper through Audible if I have a matching Kindle ebook, for example. And this means that if you get a BookBub deal or you do some promotion on your ebook, you will get a lot more audiobook sales, as well as audiobook listeners like me watch out for this type of deal in order to get cheaper audiobooks. You can also encourage your listeners to use Amazon Audible Matchmaker, which will scan your Kindle books and find matching audiobooks. Very cool. Try it out if you like audio. Then, of course, you can use audiobook promotion services. A new one is BookBub's Chirp at chirpbooks.com. It's only available in some territories, but it could be super powerful. Then, of course, there are things like Audiobook Boom, Audiophile Magazine, and the Audio Publishers Association at audiopub.org has lists of other ways you can market your audiobooks. Don't forget things like YouTube, where you can upload samples of your audiobooks or a trailer and link back to your audiobook as well, so that you get more sales through a multimedia platform. I've put a sample chapter of successful self-publishing on YouTube at thecreativepen.com/sample chapter. If you're doing a lot of live marketing and you want to hand out cards, for example, you can add a QR code, which is a sort of square image that people can scan with their cell phone, and it will take them to a sales page. That can be a really good way to sell audio or ebooks if you're doing more physical print marketing. And then, of course, audio sells audio. And one of my favorite ways to market my audiobooks is to go on podcast interviews. People who listen to podcasts, like me, also like to listen to audiobooks. And in fact, that's what I do most days when I'm cooking or out for a walk. I might switch between a podcast and then an audiobook as I walk. And it's a way that I read fiction and nonfiction, mostly nonfiction. But certainly, if you have an interview on a podcast, then having audiobooks available is a really good idea, because those who choose to listen to podcasts are often a great audience for audiobooks. Just a couple more ideas. When you're choosing a narrator, you could pick a narrator with a following already within your genre, because many listeners will follow a narrator whose voice they like. And if it's in the same genre, they're more likely to buy your book. Now, this might be tough if your favourite narrator is very well known, but many narrators can be hired by independent authors just as much as they can be by publishers. So give it a go. And then finally, think about all the different types of products you could do in audio. It doesn't just have to be one really big book. It could be short stories. It could be an audiobook box set. There are lots of different products that you could do in audio that will bring people into your audio ecosystem and make them more likely to buy your books. Okay, well, I hope that's given you some ideas for how to market your audiobooks. And for more information on everything to do with audiobooks, podcasting, and voice technologies, check out my book, Audio for Authors. Yes, available in audiobook edition as well as ebook and print and large print and hardback editions. Available in all the usual places, or you can go to thecreativepen.com/books for all the links. Happy writing, happy listening, and I'll see you next time.